prior health issues, right?
No, he sure didn't. As a matter of fact, in February 2006, Joey Leger was having a massive heart attack and didn't even know it. Take a look at how one decision will change his life forever.
I thought maybe I just had like chest congestion or something like that because it was the winter months. So I waited till the Monday morning to go to my regular doctor, and he admitted me into the hospital, and that's when they realized I was having a massive heart attack.
After surgery in 2006, Joey Leger was given a stent, a small mesh tube used to treat narrow or weak arteries.
There's little spider veins that have grown around the occlusion of the stent, and that's basically what's keeping me alive, but there's not enough blood that's pumping through those veins to get to the vital organs.
Because of this, Joey did some research. He decided an implantable ventricular assist device, or IVAD, which is a total heart replacement, is the best option for him. Risky, but could be the difference between life or death.
Anything that we put into the body can be infection. Anytime we do heart surgery, bleeding, and sometimes if we replace the function of the left side of the heart only, then the right side of the heart can fail.
The IVAD helps in two different cases, for those who it's their last option, or for those like Joey who need time until a heart transplant can be found. Once the IVAD is implanted, Joey will be left open for 48 hours.
That's a technique to make sure that both the device implantation has worked, as well as it has such a high risk of bleeding early on. And so if you close the chest cavity over where you put in this new artificial heart and you get bleeding and it has nowhere else to go, then you can really get into trouble.
For Joey, the IVAD is a life-saving device. It will do 80% of the work, and his heart will only have to do 20.
Oh, I'm just looking forward to getting back to normal, you know, or what I consider normal, you know, so let's just pray that it works.
Now, doctors say the body naturally tries to reject the IVADs, so they zip the immune system down to zero, and patients are placed on anti-rejection drugs as long as the device is in the body. Now, Joey will undergo surgery next week. We'll keep you updated on his recovery. But in the meantime, a benefit will be held for him September 28th, featuring bands, a live auction, and food. For more info on the event, head to KATC.com. Live in the studio, Kristen Holloway. Good morning, Acadiana.
Time now is 6:38, still to come on GMA. Parish President Joey Durrell is in with us this morning. We'll talk to him in just a bit. Also, Scott is on the road this morning. He's got